Welcome to e-learning course on Applied Thermodynamics, Module 1, Air Standard Cycles and IC Engine, Session 3, Auto Cycle. Myself Ramesh B.R., Assistant Professor in the Department of Mechanical Engineering, Jain Institute of Technology, Davanagere. Auto Cycle. Auto Cycle is a theoretical cycle on which petrol, gasoline and gas engines work. The heat is supplied and rejected by means of a source and sink when alternatively brought in contact with the cylinder head. The cycle consists of two constant volume and two isentropic processes as shown in figure. We make use of a piston cylinder arrangement which is taken as perfect insulator excluding cylinder head. With the help of PV and TS diagram, we are going to see how a auto cycle is going to work. A heat source and a heat sink as well as an insulator is used here, which are alternatively brought in contact with the cylinder head. The piston is made to move from position 1 to position 2 inwardly and from position 3 to position 4 outwardly. Now we see the different processes involved in auto cycle. The first process is from point 1 to point 2, which is isentropic compression process, where the piston is made to move from position 1 to position 2. During this process, due to compression of working substance, as the piston moves from position 1 to position 2, temperature is going to increase, but it is an isentropic process. To have an isentropic process, we are going to place a heat insulator near the cylinder head, making heat transfer equal to zero. That is, no heat transfer will be there from the working substance to the surrounding. The second process is constant volume heat addition process, taking place from point 2 to point 3. The volume is maintained constant here by locking the piston at position 2 firmly. During this process, heat is added using a heat source placing near the cylinder head. And the third process is from point 3 to point 4, which is isentropic expansion process. Expansion is carried out by moving piston from point 3 to point 4, and the process is isentropic. So, no heat transfer will be there from the system to the surrounding. To attain that, a heat insulator is placed near the cylinder head. And the last process here is constant volume heat rejection process carried out from point 4 to point 1. To maintain volume constant, the piston is firmly locked at position 4 and heat is transferred from the system to the surrounding by placing a heat sink near the cylinder head. Now we see the processes one by one. The first process is from point 1 to point 2, which is named as isentropic compression process. Here the temperature rises from T1 to T2, you can observe in your TS diagram. The pressure rises from P1 to P2 in your PV diagram. This is because of rising temperature, and because of compression, the piston is moved from position 1 to position 2. As a result, volume decreases from V1 to V2. For this process, work done on the system per kg can be written as P1 V1 minus P2 V2 over gamma minus 1, where P1 V1 is the initial pressure and volume, and P2 V2 is the final pressure and volume during the process 1 to 2. Gamma represents the ratio of specific heat. Based on perfect gas equation, that is PV is equal to RT, we can replace PV with RT, and finally the expression becomes R into T1 minus T2 over gamma minus 1. By the definition of specific heat at constant volume, we have the relation that Cv is equal to R over gamma minus 1, and R over gamma minus 1 is replaced with Cv in this expression, and the expression becomes Cv into T1 minus T2. To interchange the term T1 and T2, we are going to introduce a negative sign here, and the final expression for work done during the process 1 to 2 becomes minus Cb into T2 minus T1, and this is the expression for work done on the system per kg. In this expression, the negative sign is going to represent work done on the system. Next is adiabatic heat transfer. The reason for adiabatic, the process is isentropic. So, isentropic means a reversible adiabatic process. So, heat transfer will be 0, you can notice in your TS diagram. So, during the process 1 to 2, heat transfer will be 0. So, heat transfer is 0 for adiabatic heat transfer per kg. Then we can write relationships between pressure, volume and temperature. Considering only volume and temperature, we know Tv to the power of gamma minus 1 is equal to constant. Writing this relation to state point 1 and state point 2, we will get T1 V1 to the power of gamma minus 1, which is equal to T2 V2 to the power of gamma minus 1. And by rearranging this term, we will get T2 over T1 is equal to V1 over V2 whole to the power of gamma minus 1. Here V1 means it is a total volume of the cylinder. This you can observe here. This is a total volume of the cylinder, and V2 is the clearance volume of the cylinder when the piston is at position 2. So, the ratio of total volume to clearance volume is called as compression ratio. So, V1 over V2 is replaced with RC. RC means compression ratio. And the final relation what we will get here is T2 is equal to T1 RC gamma minus 1. Moving on to next process, which is constant volume heat addition process taking place from point 2 to point 3. Here temperature rises from T2 to T3 as a result of heat addition. Heat is added with the help of heat source in this case. As the temperature rises, pressure also rises from P2 to P3, you can observe in your PV diagram, but volume remains constant. So, piston is firmly locked at position 2, maintain volume constant. So, the volume remains constant as V2 is equal to V3. Work done per kg when the volume is constant is 0. So, work 2, 3 will be equal to 0. And heat is added during the process 2-3, and it is given by Q23, which is equal to Cv into T3 minus T2. So, this expression is based on the definition given for specific heat at constant volume, that is Cv, which is given by heat addition or heat transfer over change in temperature. So, based on that, heat addition during constant volume process is given by Cv multiplied by final temperature minus initial temperature in that process. And next is cutoff ratio, which is an important ratio to be followed in auto cycle. Cutoff ratio is going to define where to stop heat addition during the process, and it is denoted by alpha, and it is equal to ratio of temperature, that is final temperature to the initial temperature in the process. So we can write alpha equal to T3 over T2. So by rearranging the terms, we can finally write T2 is equal to alpha into T2. That is T3 equal to alpha into T2. And from the previous process, we know that T2 is equal to T1 into RC gamma minus 1. So finally, we will get T3 equal to alpha into T1 into RC gamma minus 1. And this is the expression which we will get from process 2-3. Moving on to next one, the third process, that is isentropic expansion process. Here the temperature decreases from T3 to T4 because of expansion. So you can observe in your TS diagram. So temperature decreases from T3 to T4. As a result, pressure also decreases from P3 to P4. Volume increases because of movement of piston from position 3 to position 4. Work done by the system during expansion process is given by P3 V3 minus P4 V4 over gamma minus 1. So this is based on the adiabatic work. Here P3 V3 means it is a initial pressure and volume at state point 3, and P4 V4 is the final volume at state point 4, or initial and final based on the process 3 and 4. And with the help of PV diagram, you can observe the initial state as 0.3 and final state as 0.4. Now we have PV is equal to RT, that is perfect gas equation. Using that, here we can write expression as R T3 minus T4 over gamma minus 1, and we can replace R over gamma minus 1 as CV, and the final expression for work becomes CV into T3 minus T4, and the work expression here will be positive because work is done by the system. Next is adiabatic heat transfer. We know that adiabatic heat transfer means heat transfer will be 0. Next, we can establish relation between pressure, volume and temperature. We will consider only volume and temperature here. So we know the relation TV to the power of gamma minus 1 is equal to constant. So writing this relation to 0.3 and 0.4 for the process 3-4, we will get this expression T3 V3 gamma minus 1 is equal to T4 V4 gamma minus 1. So writing this in the form of temperature ratio, we will get T4 over T3, which is equal to V3 over V4. Whole to the power of gamma minus 1. So with the help of your PV diagram, you can say that V3 is equal to V2 and V4 is equal to V1. So we will going to replace V3 with V2 as well as V4 with V1. And V1 means here it is a total volume of the cylinder, and V2 means it is a clearance volume of the cylinder. So we know that total volume to clearance volume is equal to compression ratio, that is RC. Here it is clearance volume to total volume, so we will write it as 1 over RC, and the expression here becomes T4 over T3 is equal to 1 over RC gamma minus 1. Now from the previous process, we know the relation for T3, that is T3 is equal to alpha T1 RC gamma minus 1. So now we are going to simplify for RC gamma minus 1. After simplification, the final expression we will get here is T4 is equal to alpha into T1. Moving on to the last process, that is process 4-1, which is constant volume heat rejection process. temperature decreases from T4 to T1 as a result of heat rejection. As the temperature decreases, pressure also decreases from P4 to P1, but volume is maintained constant by firmly locking the piston at position 4. So here V4 will be equal to V1. Work done per kg for constant volume process will be 0, as there is no change in volume, and heat addition or rejection per kg. So in this case it is heat rejection per kg can be written as Q41, which is equal to Cv into final temperature minus initial temperature. By interchanging the temperature terms, we will get minus Cv into T4 minus T1, and this complete expression is based on the definition given for specific heat at constant volume. So now the final expression for heat rejection is minus Cv into T4 minus T1. Here the negative sign represents heat rejection taking place from the working substance. Now we see one of the important performance parameter which is used to analyze Otto cycle, that is thermal efficiency. We make use of a TS diagram to obtain the expression for thermal efficiency of Otto cycle. Thermal efficiency is defined as the ratio of net work done to heat added. Net work done means here it is a sum of all the heat transfer, or it is a sum of all the work transfer. Either you can take heat transfer or work transfer. So I have considered heat transfer in this case. So net work done can be written as sum of all the heat transfer. We have two heat transfers, one is heat addition and heat rejection. Heat addition takes place from 2 to 3 and heat rejection takes place from 4 to 1. So Q21, 2 to 3 plus Q41 is the heat addition as well as heat rejection, and by summing these two heat we will get net work done. And heat added is during the process 2 to 3, so we have taken heat added as Q23. And we know the expressions for heat addition as well as heat rejection from the previous processes which we have discussed earlier. So heat added is given by Cv into T3 minus T2. Heat rejection is equal to minus Cv into T4 minus T1. Here negative sign will come because it is heat rejection, and over Cv into T3 minus T2, which is heat added. So Cv term remains same in all the three terms, so it get cancelled and the expression becomes T3 minus T2 minus T4 minus T1 over T3 minus T2. Now we are going to separate the numerator term into two part, so we will get T3 minus T2 over T3 minus T2, which is equal to 1. And T4 minus T1 over T3 minus T2 is the second term what we will get. Now from process 1 to 2 we have T2 is equal to T1 RC gamma minus 1, and from T3 we have alpha T1 RC gamma minus 1, and from the process 4-1 we have T4 is equal to alpha T1. These are the three relations established from the different processes of Otto cycle. Now we are going to replace T4 with alpha T1, T3 with alpha T1 RC gamma minus 1, and T2 with T1 RC gamma minus 1. And this is the expression what we will get after replacing for T4, T3 and T2. In this expression, T1 is common in the numerator part. In the denominator part here, T1 RC gamma minus 1 is common, it is taken outside. And the final expression becomes 1 minus T1 into alpha minus 1 over RC gamma minus 1 into T1 into alpha minus 1. So T1 alpha minus 1 is same in numerator as well as denominator, it get cancelled. And the final expression here for thermal efficiency of Otto cycle is equal to 1 minus 1 over RC to the power of gamma minus 1, where RC means compression ratio. So now we see some of the important parameters related to thermal efficiency expression. The air standard efficiency of Otto cycle depends only on compression ratio, that is RC. So we can observe only RC term in the expression, that's why it depends only on compression ratio. The efficiency of Otto cycle increases with increase in compression ratio. As we increase the compression ratio, so efficiency will increases, that is observation what we can make. So, and the practical value for RC generally lies between 5 to 10 for Otto cycle. Moving on to next one, the second performance parameter, that is mean effective pressure. So, mean effective pressure is defined as net work done over shaft volume. So, net work done means it is sum of all the work or sum of all the heat transfer. I have taken heat transfer in this case. So, sum of heat transfer means here heat added plus heat rejected over shaft volume, which is taken as Vs. So, heat added takes place from 2 to 3 and heat rejection takes place from 4 to 1. That is the thing what we have written here. And expression for heat added is Cv into T3 minus T2. And expression for heat rejection is minus Cv into TE4 minus T1. And shaft volume is written as V1 minus V2. You can observe in your PV diagram. Shaft volume means it is a volume from 0.2 to 0.1. So, to get this value, so we have to take total volume minus clearance volume. So, total volume is V1 and the clearance volume is V2. If you take the difference between total volume and the clearance volume, you will get the shaft volume, and that is the thing what you have written here, V1 minus V2. From process 1 to 2, we have T2 is equal to T1 RC gamma minus 1, T3 is equal to alpha T1 RC gamma minus 1, and T4 is equal to alpha T1. And these are the from different processes of Otto cycle, which has been already discussed. Now, we are going to replace for T3, T2 as well as T4 in the numerator part with these relations, and we will get this expression. In this expression, we are going to take T1 RC gamma minus 1 as common in this bracket, and here T1 as common, and overall Cv T1 RC, not RC, Cv T1 and Cv T1, from these two terms are taken common here. And finally, we will get Cv T1 into RC gamma minus 1 multiplied with alpha minus 1 minus alpha minus 1 over V2 into V1 over minus 1. Since we know that P1 V1 is equal to RT1, so we can write T1 is equal to P1 V1 over R. So, T1 is replaced with this expression P1 V1 over R, that is done here. And we know that R is equal to Cv into gamma minus 1. So, Cv is replaced with R over gamma minus 1 here, Cv is replaced with R over gamma minus 1, and V1 over V2 is written as RC. So, and the expression becomes Cv into P1 RC alpha minus 1 RC gamma minus 1 minus 1 over Cv into gamma minus 1 RC minus 1. So, Cv get cancelled, and the final expression for mean effective pressure of Otto cycle is P1 RC alpha minus 1 RC gamma minus 1 minus 1 over gamma minus 1 RC minus 1. And this is the expression which is used to obtain mean effective pressure of a Otto cycle. And this is the end of the session on Otto cycle. Thank you very much. Please do subscribe to my channel BR Mech Academic.